Com, a unique place for true gamers. The only place to bet on esports events. You know your way around a competitive gaming scene and are willing to take a risk? Watch regular broadcasts and earn real money. Esportsbets.com. Foresight, passion, and calculation.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to get it on. This is the SLTV Starseries Finals between HellRaisers and NaVi. And it's been about time. We've been through a long break, but now we're finally ready. So welcome to Room on Fire and this great game. Samurai and Vendetta, are you both here still?
I am, at least. Semler's probably not far away.
Well, he should be here any second, probably. I mean, this break was a bit longer than we anticipated, because Fnatic did win pretty impressively against my XMG, but at least now we have what should be a very, very interesting match on our hands here. And I don't know, this is the match I think that's going to be really, really fun to see, because NaVi, they're the defending champions. They won SLTV last time around. And HellRaisers, well, they've been bootcamping and practicing a lot. Their run during Gamescom Cologne was not like they wanted it to be. They got knocked out of the group stages and never made it to the playoffs. So I'm sure they want to see if they can change that.
Yeah,
make it better this time.
Yeah, absolutely. And you could tell that HellRaisers are putting a lot of effort into this finals. For sure, seeing how, well, obviously they played the Case King tournament versus NIP, and they were really adamant about not giving out the demos to the public before this tournament was over.
Yeah,
and you can't really blame them, because they had a pretty underwhelming performance at Gamescom, and they did put a lot of time and effort into practicing for that event, so I'm sure they expected more than a group stage exit.
Probably did. I mean, they had been back. I think actually HellRaisers had been moon camping more than anyone else before Gamescom. I think they'd been moon camping for something like 2 weeks. It was really quite impressive.
Probably just the American teams who would match them.
Yeah, maybe some of the American teams, you're right. But apart from that, it's mainly it was mainly HellRaisers, I think, that they really put in the work. And I mean, they just ran into some tough opponents and had some really rough best of one games that they couldn't make it through. Epsilon being maybe the worst upset that was happening there. Now, the map pool for this game, vetoing out was, or NaVi vetoed already Nuke. HellRaisers has been vetoing Train, so that leaves us with Dust 2, picked by NaVi, Inferno, picked by HellRaisers, and then Mirage as the deciding map. So, I mean, we do only have the 5-map map pool here, so it's not with the new maps and everything else, and that makes it some of the map picks a little bit more predictable, because everyone could have told us that that Nuke was going to be out from NaVi. And probably Train from HellRaisers is not a bad call either.
No, especially seeing how little we see of Train after it got taken out from, I guess, the official map rotation,
well,
right?
Not only that, but it's one of Na'Vi's better maps, right? Train. Like, they've always done well on it. They have their particular positions on it. Guardian is way too scary on it. So it's a perfect ban, basically, for HellRaisers going into this match.
But the question is, do teams still practice Train? Seeing how it's starting to get left out from more and more tournaments.
Yeah, I seriously doubt that a team would. That would seem a very bad idea, in my opinion, to be practicing Train.
Yeah. So, but I think it's a really good map pool. We know that NaVi are a good team on Dust 2. Normally, we have seen some hiccups from them on this map, but we know that HellRaisers are excellent on Inferno, and they've shown that the last couple of weeks, that they, barring that one game versus Epsilon really at Gamescom, they've been really good at on Inferno.
Yep. It should be a very interesting best of three, and I could go either way. On Mirage, I mean, that's Navi's pretty, they might be one of the best teams in the world.
Yeah.
Between NaVi and VP and a couple of other teams, I'd say NaVi are candidate for the top one on Mirage. So if it goes to that map, could be scary for HellRaisers. Not that they're bad at it, but just
I'd actually say it's pretty even, because, well, they did play in the regular season of SLTV, right? Mm. And that was on Mirage, and it ended 15-15. And the big thing about that game is, because you talked about how Guardian went, you know, that typically Guardian goes huge and all that stuff.
Mm.
Guardian dropped 37 frags in
and
that game.
Couldn't do it.
Exactly.
Yeah, I remember that. You're right. I mean, this is definitely not a sure thing, and there's a lot of other stuff going on here. Just like when we see French teams playing other French teams or Swedish teams playing other Swedish teams, we always talk about sort of the domestic factor. And I guess between HellRaisers and NaVi, it's not quite a domestic factor because we do have both Russian, Ukrainian, and Slovakian players, and also Adrian from Kazakhstan, so it's a little bit all over the place. But it's as close as I think it can get to an all domestic matchup in the CIS region. And not only that, these people have been on, you know, teams with each other, so they know a lot about what they're doing.
Yeah, they've been together for quite some time, but we can't not mention Seized, essentially, in a NaVi match, especially at Star Series, because that was kind of like that big opportunity that we saw Seized take the last time when NaVi actually took this tournament. They are the title holders of Star Series right now. They're the defending champs. So yeah. NaVi are the team, I think, that have a bit of an edge going into this. If all things are going to be even, right, you know, just the fact that they are the ones holding on to the title from before, that's huge for NaVi. But the guys, you know, it's like, okay, we talk about Guardian a lot, and with his AWP, of course, you know, he's a force of nature, but the man to watch is Seized, I think, because he is so crucial for NaVi to perform well. If Seized is doing well, NaVi does well, and they really demonstrated that the last Star Series.
I would actually double down on that. I think you're absolutely right in that. And it's a little bit weird because it's not like Seized is the only one who could be doing well. It could just as well be. I mean, we've seen stunning performances from Edward, but somehow I think you're right. It's weird that Seized seems to be sort of the marker or the indicator for how well the rest of the team is doing. So I'm gonna go with that. On the other team, I think, you know, Markolov's performance is going to be really, really important, and I think Doja is just always the key person.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, like, Doja is so much more consistent for HellRaisers. Like, it really feels like now he's starting to come into his own. Like, we can expect to see him at the top of the scoreboard, like we're supposed to see, basically. Doja has to be the point man. Now it's going to be a question of whether the rest of the team, you know, i.e. Markolov or Adrian, can really step in there and start carrying some weight as well. So I think that's more of the question for HellRaisers. Doja's been very consistent. Now what do the rest of the team have to offer? Are they going to be able to step up to the plate and help him basically get them a victory?
I actually, one guy who I don't think get enough praise for how much he's elevated his play, not just over the last few months, but just from maybe 1.5 year ago in CSGO till now, that's Kucher.
Yeah,
damn straight.
Yeah. Kucher has kind of been, in many ways, the anchor of this HellRaisers teams in many ways, especially with the way that he's been able to pick up the AWP and actually provide HellRaisers with a kind of a safe option to go with in a lot of games. Simply because he's not the aggressive offer who runs out into crazy peaks and try to get interfrags that way. He's the kind of guy who just calmly sits in a position and waits for you in an angle, and he's extremely good at that. And he's able to get openings for HellRaisers, he's able to shut down pushes. He's kind of a jack of all trades in many ways for HellRaisers, and I think if he comes up big for HellRaisers, they have a good shot at beating NaVi.
Well, wasn't it just the last night that we saw HellRaisers, like, in the match versus NiP, I think it was Kucher who was top fragging for HellRaisers.
Yeah, Kucher was playing really well.
That's the thing. It's like, okay, Doja was doing well, Kucher was doing well, you know, but they still weren't able to eke out the win. They still weren't quite able to get it. So now we have to see if they can today, if NaVi are going to falter here, trying to defend their title.
Guys, before we go live, folks, just a reminder that we are giving away one of these Cyrix M4A1s in the later today for one lucky subscriber. So we'll remind you later. We'll do it at the end of the day because we have some great games coming up still. Just forgot about that, but we'll do that. Thanks to Stony for handing us that off. Now, we're going to be ready. NaVi starting on the CT side, and it will be HellRaisers on the terrorist side here of Dust 2. So welcome to the show. And it looks like it's going to be a bit of a split for A, and I wouldn't be surprised if they're actually going to be a little bit fast with it because they're already setting up quite aggressively. And this is a problem for NaVi. If they start losing people right now, they're going to get sandwiched in on long. And Starix does a great job of holding. Very important kill. Guardian and Guardian with a double. And that leaves the rest of the push completely impotent to get this A-bomb site. Angel in a 1-on-5. Solid hold here, especially from Guardian with that triple kill. But Vendetta, do you agree there was a danger there for HellRaisers? Or sorry, for NaVi out on long?
Oh, absolutely. It looked like HellRaisers had a pretty decent setup towards long right there. I think it was Markloff who was standing a bit away from the long cave there to flash them out. But it didn't really seem like HellRaisers actually got out. It was only Adren who was able to get really out of long cave and actually take the fight towards the guy in pit. And the rest of them kind of just stood still doing not all that much. And that was the big issue.
Yeah, and if they had got the opening, I mean, maybe there would have been some sort of sandwich effect going on. Good grenade and a follow-up headshot as well from Seuss is going to kill Markolov and Kucha both. They did not get the bomb plant in the first round. They're going to try this round. Angel is not going to get it done. So, solid defense. This time, Seuss picking up a quad kill. This is a pretty good start, Semler.
Oh yeah, this is going to definitely make Na'Vi pretty confident so far. Even Guardian setting up aggressively at the mid doors early on gets smoked off, no problem. He starts taking shots at this P250 and almost drops Angel straight up from suicide. So Na'Vi are doing some damage already to HellRaisers. HellRaisers are the guys who are now going to have to fight back in the fourth round when they're finally going to have the money to buy. Because, you know, yeah, okay, they haven't managed to get a plant yet. So HellRaisers, you know, they have to bide their time and really put their all into this next round that's going to be coming up here.
Guardian being really annoying in the middle, looking for a kill. And actually, they'll not only kill Guardian, they'll almost kill Edward as well. So Na'Vi should be careful. Yes, they had a great start, but they had one guy who just had a pistol and he's already gone. And if they lose Edward as well, well, you don't want to open up anything for HellRaisers yet. That'd be meaningless.
No, but I like Na'Vi's setup now. They just fall back onto the site. So they have two guys holding solid on B. Seized is looking towards mid from window, but he isn't outside of B site proper. So if it was going to be a B play, they'd be able to react very quickly. And still over on A site, Na'Vi, one guy set up towards long, looking towards cat, and the other one looking towards long house. So they should be able to hold here, Na'Vi, with the rifles.
Kucha and Starix, or Seuss and Starix speaking of kill each. It's Angel and Kucha who go down. Grenade to follow. Are they going to get the bomb plant this time? They will get the bomb down. So that's an extra $800 bonus for everybody on that team. And even a kill coming in there from Adrian. So that's not half bad. That's two people killed and a bomb plant. I mean, they were going to be able to buy an extra round anyway, but now they can actually buy a lot more. Just look at this. Everyone except for Dozier above 6,000. It's not bad.
Not too shabby at all, and we could see Markolov picking up that AWP, so that extra money coming into good use right now for HellRaisers.
Yeah, and he's down to $100, so, you know, if he hadn't had that, he could have still got the ult, but he would have had no grenades at all, and that can be a vital difference here. Guardian is actually going to get boosted up onto short. Takes a little bit of time, weirdly, and that's a problem, because if you're going to do this boost, you want to be really quick about it. Markolov waiting in the middle, Seuss goes for the spray and very nearly takes down the opposing AWPer. But actually, you know, imagine if that had been Guardian in place instead of Seuss.
Now, when they do a boost like that, you would have imagined that it's Guardian actually doing that.
Kind of an aggressive move into B right now, and already they've lost Dozier and also Angel, and Kucha will get the return, but it might be way too late. The bomb is dropped on short here, and Na'Vi have pretty much a perfect setup right now to deal with it. They have control of short, they've got two people on the A bomb site. Edward is going to go down though. This is still a 2-on-3 that's going to be very, very tough to handle. Adrian very nearly catches Seuss and actually will catch him. So maybe the too careless play coming in from Na'Vi.
They still got the molly to throw down on Cat to delay things further. 50 seconds left on this clock means Adrian has a lot of time, but Guardian has got the position and instant kill. As soon as Adrian comes around that corner trying to pick up that bomb, Guardian puts him to rest, and that's Na'Vi regaining control of the situation. And I don't think Na'Vi are going to be too flustered with having lost so many guys. At that point, in that round, it's more about just getting that round away from HellRaisers than at no matter the cost, than just keeping everybody alive.
Yeah, but for me, that still looked like a bit of a worrying sign that they... Because once they had the bomb and Seuss spotted the bomb, I feel like they should have made a better job. It might be a tiny detail because they did win the round, but it seemed like there was a little bit of hesitation maybe going on the Na'Vi side. But 4-0 is nothing to sneeze at, and HellRaisers as well, they force a buy this time with a scout and a Galil as well.
It's going to be another B-split push here, actually. They're straight out from mid-doors. There's one man waiting in upper dark, but right now, Na'Vi have to worry more about stopping them from getting in through the window, and they've got the crossfire set up. Edward and Seized cutting him down, and Guardian now lending a hand from CT spawn. Edward is still alive here, and Kucher can't get rid of him. A very fine hold coming in here from Na'Vi. Zeus is going to be the last man alive, trying to take a fight, but he's not going to get it. It's actually Adrian alive for HellRaisers, but still, 1v3, Edward hunts him down, and that's going to be another very solid hold for Na'Vi. The crossfire on B site was just brutal.
Yes, it was. But the really key thing that you managed to mention as well is that kill from Guardian, actually, the guy that was coming in through the doors from middle, he would have pretty killed the guy, the CT that was holding by cars, because he was reloading. So if Guardian hadn't got that shot, that would have maybe given HellRaisers the bomb site. That was definitely the buddy system again that we've been talking about. That was in play right there. Great backup. 5-0 right now. I mean, it's... You know, it's still early in the first half here, so we don't want to panic too much, but certainly Na'Vi are looking on form right now.
HellRaisers are doing the HellRaisers thing, which is basically forcing up whenever they have the slightest opportunity to get weapons. And, well, they do get the trade on long, which is not too shabby when you're on the T side of Dust 2, but if they're gonna do a B-split like it looks like they're setting up for right now, they have to commit harder than what they did in the previous round, because they hesitated way too much of actually going into that B-bomb site.
They're trading, or it seems like they're going to change up how they go about this B push now. Rather than going out through mid doors and being a bit too predictable, and perhaps having to deal with Guardians AWP, they're going to just double up and everybody go through upper dark, it looks like. Seized is still holding on the site proper in the corner, but Edward has now worked his way out to mid doors. This is a big mistake from NaVi. They are about to get overwhelmed here.
Oh, but then Seized picks up that double, so leaves Markolov now in a strange one-on-two. Has picked up an AK. And now would be a great time to clutch a 1-on-2 for Markolov. And if there's a guy who can do it, it might just be him. Flashbang out the middle here, leaves Guardian completely flashed, and Starix is not in a position to deny the bomb, so it will go down. It's the first victory for HellRaisers now. They just need the rest.
Markolov, he's looking towards Starix in upper dark. Starix walks right into it. There's a clean headshot. 1v1 now, but Guardian knows exactly where he is. But Markolov, he gets the peek. Perfect headshot. He sees exactly where Guardian's going to be holding from. He can't go and pick up the AWP. He's not fast enough, but still, that shot was perfect.
Absolutely stunning. That looked so effortless from Markolov. That is exactly the style they need, and they need a lot more of it. That has to give some confidence back to the terrorist side as well, just knowing that they can actually do that. That was a sick play from Markolov.
Well, that's going to give HellRaisers a breath of fresh air, isn't it?
It should. It definitely should. But then Starix immediately takes something away from them. Guardian is up here, and he does spot Angel down there. Only going to do a bit of a grenade. Actually, a lot of grenade damage. Look at that. 53 in one grenade. Angel must have almost tried to eat that grenade for it to do that much damage. And look at what Starix is doing. This is what we saw Fnatic with JW doing on this side, on the CT side, holding very aggressively by long doors here.
He loves to do it. I mean, you're listening as well. You can hear for top mid there, and as soon as you hear them stepping away, look at what Starks is doing. Tries to sneak out, and he's going to get one kill on Markolov. Angel manages to return and pick off Zeus at mid-doors, but still, they still have to worry about Starks, who's kind of floating around. He's dropped the bomb carrier, and Doja has to come back here and root him out before they can get their plan rolling again.
He's not going to be able to either. He takes down one, and that's a triple kill from Starix. Incredible play. And you're absolutely right. Even if he hadn't got those kills, they would have still had to worry about him. Kucha will take down Starix, but it's too little too late. That's actually a quad kill, sorry, for Starix at the very end here. So if he had picked up Kucha, that would have been an ace. But he's done plenty already. And with 25 seconds, there's actually just no chance that Kucha can win this any longer. It's not possible. Mathematically impossible for him to do it.
Well... Seized has already got the right angle. Edward is going to bait himself, and well, he gets the kill regardless, but even if Edward goes down, Seized is in position to capitalize and take Kucher out. And this is about what? This is worst case scenario now for HellRaisers. Look at this. Their money has been reset completely. This is what we always fear will happen is you win one round, you feel great, and you're thinking, okay, now we can have an impact, and then you get shut down immediately. So you're back to $0. Your opponents survive, and it just gets that much harder because you're running out of rounds in the half.
Guardian, very aggressive setup in the middle, even though they must have guessed it. This is going to be an eco round from HellRaisers, because they can predict the economy like that. Guardian's still just going hyper-aggressive. They're really not letting HellRaisers get any foot on the map right now. I mean, what do you say, Vendetta? This is looking like a Na'Vi that is not just here to compete, but here to defend the title.
Oh, they definitely look on point, and the game, like, the way the game was playing out is very similar to what we saw in the first game of the day, between Fnatic and MyXMG.
Yeah. Well, I would almost say right now it looks like HellRaisers have even less of a chance than MyXMG did, which is curious.
Well, I'm not going to throw HellRaisers under the bus quite yet, but they are definitely struggling. But this is the kind of shape that we wanted to see Na'Vi in. I mean, if you're the defending champ, you need to be showing people that you've got some fight in you.
Guardian down here, not going to miss a shot. They keep pushing, they need to kill him, and they will. Excellent shot for Markolov. Now Starix is next in line, and he's already been shot in the face once. Molotov comes out here, grenade to follow, could kill Markolov, but it's not going to connect, and the bomb will go down, and now it's a 4-on-3. Great job from HellRaisers. They need a lot more of this right now. They got to win this round. Seized comes up, we've been talking about him, and he's actually going to run out of bullets. Angel jumping down in the pit. What's going on? This is just a complete chaos round from both sides, but it's HellRaisers who come out on top. And now the unable to maintain in the round, so great job from the T's. Edwards gonna go down, and that's Angel and Markolov with a double kill each.
I think that was a bit of a weird rotation from Navi's point. They had so many people committed to going up from CT spawn towards that A bomb site instead of actually moving anyone at all, really, towards catwalk. So it was just a huge clump of Navi players, barring the one guy towards long. And that made it really easy for HellRaisers to defend because they had the superior positions going into that.
Yeah, maybe they did. But from HellRaisers' point of view, it means there's now a 5-round gap. And they need to keep building. I mean, if they can end up... I think we've seen teams come back from having like 6 or 7 rounds on the T side. But I think they get less than 6 rounds. I think it's going to be too much. Edward with the opening kill, and Edward gets a double... Finally, someone else goes down, and Markolov point blank takes down Edwards. So now there's a real opening for this B bomb site, unless Seize has something to say about it.
He's looking. I mean, Seize is still alive on this site right now. So long as he stays alive in a good position, this gets really difficult for HellRaisers to crack this site. Only problem is that Na'Vi aren't sure exactly if it's going to be a short play or if it's going to be a B play, and so they've rotated a man back to the A site proper, that's Starix now, getting onto that bomb site. Guardian is still in CT with his AWP, but he's been smoked off. That smoke clears, but HellRaisers are not going to be coming through mid. It's all going to come down to Seized here to stop this push.
He picks off one and then goes down. That's pretty good. It could have been even better. Guardian waiting for someone to cross over. And this is what Guardian is good at. He's actually going to hit that shot on Markolov, I think.
I think he tagged them down, yeah. I think he must have got him through the doors there.
Yeah, doors and maybe even doors and boxes. I mean, he didn't do that much damage. Adrian here has a great position, and the timing is going to be perfect. Guardian is going to go down, leaving Starix in a pretty awkward spot here. He spots Markolov, knows he's up by the window, but one shot of the AWP is going to be enough here. And Starix, oh, that smoke would have been good, but now it might be too late. He spots Markolov, and he's going to go down. Great triple. Markolov makes it work again. He's really carrying his team back into this game, and that's what they need. They need someone to do it, Markolov or really anyone. And I guess the other person to do it might have been Dosha, except he's got only one kill so far in these first 10 rounds.
Yeah, which is and he's seen him come back in the past from like 0 kills to 15 or 20. So I mean, he can do it. The big thing there in that round, and it was something that we needed to talk about a little bit earlier on before the play began, was that it was crucial for both teams because either team losing that round was going to eco. And now they're just, I mean, Guardian is holding. Guardian with 2 headshots, P250 up close, and he has the time to reload as well.
He actually got a 3rd headshot. That was through the door, and Markolov's on 8 health. And now coming up from behind, Edward's going to take a kill. They finally get rid of Guardian. But is it too late? That was an absolutely stunning hold. Now, they have the A-bomb site. Susie's strangely miles away from the action, but Edward has an AWP. And that bomb is going to go down. Susie's going to get here in time.
Zeus is gonna get here, and there you go. Edward with the AWP picks off Angel. Doja faces Edward, though, takes him out. And now, the question is whether Zeus can find the angle on Doja here. Zeus has picked up an AK, so he's got the right rifle to go for this, but Doja will play very well there and hold him off. The big thing there is there was clearly confusion on HellRaiser's side once they got onto that site. I mean, Angel just naded Doja at long when Doja was clearly alone. So I'm wondering how rattled HellRaisers are right now. The pressure may be getting to them.
I think the chaos that ensued around that long cave area was a bit too much to handle for HellRaisers, but they do manage to bring it back, luckily for them, and it would have been destruction, complete destruction for them to actually lose versus that eco.
Yeah, definitely would have. Angel up here on short, it's gonna get taken down. Guardian just walks in with the AWP like it's a shotgun and takes down Angel, and that's another style that he's very well known for. It's really scary, and in the meantime, the rest of Na'Vi have actually cleared both upper and lower dark, so they know, well, they know where HellRaisers aren't, and that's basically just as good as knowing where they are, because the map is not that big.
They're expecting it to be a quick play from HellRaisers, but HellRaisers, you know, giving Na'Vi a bit of a taste of their own medicine, pretty much taking their time with this. Zeus is going to go and clear out short. There's still a man waiting around the corner that's Doja, but he fails to land the shot, and Zeus even spots another man mid, so that's a lot of information there gained for Na'Vi. They still haven't rotated an extra man over to B. They are focusing on Cat with the defense, doubling down on it, in fact, and HellRaisers are about to walk right into it! Zeus with the double! He doesn't get the triple, but that is still a 2-on-3, now a 1-on-3 situation.
Attempted return here from Adrian. I mean, picking up a double is definitely great, but is it going to be enough? It doesn't feel like it should be. 30 seconds left. I mean, be an impressive ace if he can get this done. Edwards waiting for him. Oh my god, Adrian! Absolutely stunning. Takes down the kill, and now it's a four-man for him. He's got the bomb as well, and he's got time to plant. But Guardian knows it as well. He's running with his knife out. Look at this. This is a smart play. He wants to be there so that by the time Adrian plants, he'll have no time to fake, and Guardian can just walk in and pick the kill. Adrian's right here, and Guardian, oh, this is almost cruel. He's going to even scope and get the kill. No bomb plant. Very smart play from Guardian, but it's still very sad to see Adrian come that close to acing and pulling HellRaisers right back in, and now instead they have to eco.
That's heartbreaking. And he Guardian even times it so he denies the bomb plant too, which makes it all the worse. If Adrian could have gotten the bomb then you could say, well, sure, they managed to salvage some of the round. But them having to go back to an eco, and Doge actually buying up for some reason.
I was going to say, here we see, we get a bit of a taste of the HellRaisers flavor. That's, you know, Doge are the only one buying an AK, which means now in the upcoming round, he'll have no money to buy at all, and the rest can. And that's just slightly insane.
It's weird. It's we've seen them do this in the past as well. It's just very weird. It never really... It doesn't seem to work often enough to merit them going for that kind of buy.
I agree. It's weird. And I think HellRaisers are the only team to ever do this as well. And they do it consistently, as you said. And it still doesn't make any more sense.
I mean, yeah, that's sort of one of those things where if Doge does pick up 4 or 3 kills in that round and they win it, HellRaisers is going to be feeling really great and it'll be a bit of a comeback moment. But now they may have put themselves in an even more awkward position. Zeus actually gets caught jumping over towards Goose, and I have no idea why he wanted to do that. He even had the idea that they were going to be there. Now they've actually lost the bomb site, and this retake's not going to be that easy. Good Molotov here, jumping up onto Adrian, but it won't prevent the bomb plant.
Now the plant gets put down just in time, and good smokes as well. HellRaisers really saving a lot of nades there, so now life gets a little bit more difficult here for Na'Vi, having to work their way onto this site, and the bomb already planted. They just don't have a whole lot of time. And you can see it now. I mean, they're just planning. It seems like Na'Vi, unless they can find a pick or two really quickly here, get Guardian into position with that AWP, look towards that site, it's not really going to be feasible for them to walk in here with 5 members from HellRaisers all just sitting there.
They're looking for exit kills, and they are going to get a whole bunch of them. Angels, so far, the only one surviving. And trying to sneak out in the middle. Get spotted by Edward as well, and should be able to stay alive here. He's actually going to face, and he goes down to Starix. So HellRaisers win the round, but they lose every single member of their team, which means now they're back to 3 AKs and a couple of Galils, or maybe a Scout if they feel like it. This is, I mean, I don't know, we're in the 15th round, but that's a really bad way to lose a round. I mean, they don't have to eco or save any longer, I guess, but that's still not good.
Oh, that could have been an AK on Markloff instead of a Galil.
And it could have been more grenades on the rest as well. I mean, right now they have, what, 3 flashbangs, which means, you know, a B-split push with a smoke or anything. None of those things can happen any longer.
Look at
Zeus. Zeus is going to find Doge, and there's also a guy on long. Adrian walking in here. Guardian with the kill. Zeus will go down. But Na'Vi are really having their way with this first half.
They have no fear right now. They're just going around doing what they want this last round as well. If they finish 10-5 on CT side, they're going to be ecstatic going into the second half. So, Na'Vi, at this point, they can throw their weight around, and they come out ahead, getting that two-man, or at least that man advantage, getting 2 guys off of HellRaisers' side. Unfortunately, they can't kill off Adrian, who's been doing a lot of the work for HellRaisers, but still, this leaves them in a favorable position to just hold on to these sites. Doubling down on the B site, and Guardian picking off Adrian, as I called his name.
There's a double for Guardian, and walking through the middle there, Kucha's very close, but Guardian just doesn't care. Is going to take a 3rd kill. Right now, Guardian with 19 and outfragging everybody else on the server. Starix is the closest to him at 15. And Markolov, he's been saving his team a couple of times in this first half, but right now, it'd be more than just a save. It'd be pretty incredible if he could do this. And he's going to get grenaded and shot down. They're all coming for him. Seized will get the last frag of the half, and it will be 10-5 for the first half of this first map. We got to remember that. And this is the map that that Na'Vi picked, so they're definitely on point with it.
I'm just overall really impressed with how Na'Vi have... they got the thing is that they got the strong start, and that then allows them to have the confidence to go for more and more aggressive plays on their CT side. Pushes up mid from Zeus, for example. Starks pushing out from Longhouse. Getting into upper dark with Seized and Edward. Like, it allows you to be a bit more aggressive and take a couple more risks, because you picked up that pistol, you locked down the fourth round, and from there on out, it's like Na'Vi become twice as difficult to deal with, because you never know where they're going to be coming from at that point. What do you think, Ben? How did this half go for Na'Vi?
Oh, yeah. It's the exact way you described it. And then, again, it's very similar to how Fnatic went about it versus their Danish opponent. They get off to a great start, and they kind of just roll from there. They start playing aggressive setups on their CT side. That puts the T-side on the back heel. They start to play scared, and from there on out, your job as a CT gets so much easier. And when you have Guardian on form like he is right now, it feels like any team would have troubles going up against this.
Yeah, I mean, there is an eerie similarity between the Fnatic MyXMG match and this one, at least in the first half. I guess if HellRaisers can win this pistol round, there's no reason why they can't do to Na'Vi what Na'Vi just did to them, but it's still going to be tough. Na'Vi are looking very much on form here. So welcome to the show if you're just joining us. This is the second half of the first map here in a best of three between Na'Vi and HellRaisers for the SLTV Starseries Finals. So welcome to the show. You're at Room on Fire, and we're happy to show you some good Counter-Strike pretty much all day. So stay tuned, enjoy, and invite your friends. It looks like Na'Vi are going to be going for a bit of a long rush here, with Starix just actually covering the rest of the map, which is interesting. I guess he can go and make some noise, but they're not waiting for him, it seems like.
What? This is like... Oh, actually, they're just leading Seized off.
Yeah, this is... this. I think this is just designed to basically get a pick for Na'Vi early on.
Well, yeah. Guardian does have a smoke. Or actually, now he backs off from long, so I guess the initial idea that I had in my head is not going to follow through.
I think what Adrian is doing in the middle here, that's what Na'Vi wanted him to do. Go... Oh, but not that Adrian! Headshot on Guardian and Edward. What a sick start. I was going to say they wanted to lure him out in the open so they can try and get a pick on him, but they weren't expecting that kind of result. Ouch.
Yeah, ouch is right. That was perfect. And now, now things get very difficult here. Na'Vi just trying to press forward. Starks will not find the headshot on Angel. Angel stays alive. Doja is still here on CT Slope as well, looking for the headshot of his own, and he will get it. Almost gets the running shot on Seized. It's going to be Markloff to pick up the final frag, but HellRaisers living with four at the end of the pistol round. That's a statement from them. Saying we're perfectly capable of doing the same thing that you just did to us, Na'Vi.
And I think,
I actually think that was the way that plan should have worked. You know, you push out on long, and it's not unreasonable to assume that either someone could be pushing upper dark, where they had Zeus holding, or someone could be pushing out the middle, where they rotated two people back. So you try and catch someone from the CT side who gets a little bit too anxious, and they kind of caught Adrian. He just fired his way out of that situation.
Yeah, I was actually expecting Guardian, because I was thinking the same thing. They wanted rotations to happen, so with Guardian having a smoke, I would have expected him to smoke off cross and basically have him and Seize being like the firing squad at long, basically creating a tension and a diversion for the rest of the member.
Well, they kill Starix here, and Angel's in a lot of trouble. Runs out of bullets and also runs out of health points. It's going to go down. Guardian with the kill, and also Starix picking up one. That's going to give them the bomb plant, and they have also run away with the FAMAS, and Starix is in a cheeky position down the middle here. He's going to kill Markolov now. It's a 2-on-4, though they're very low on health. Starix is not going to pick up a second kill. Adrian and Doshia, they have to retake this. They got to win this situation.
There's no giving up at this point. They can't afford to give a free round. Good flash goes in from Doja. That's going to blind everybody here on Na'Vi. Na'Vi just trying to stay alive as best they can. Doja going for some spray and Guardian killing his own teammate. That's not going to help things, but he's into a one-on-one now. And Doja peeking through window. He knows exactly where Guardian is.
Yeah, and Guardian is going to get found. Doja, he will have not enough time, I think. Oh, no. Yeah. They get the retake, and in spite of the kill, in spite of the team kill that that Guardian got, it's still not going to win HellRaisers the round. And now they've got to be feeling very low at the moment.
Especially because Markolov did not buy up. He did not buy anything at all. So he was running around with USP and Kevlar, and he got taken out by Starix. And if he had anything, any other gun than a USP in that situation, I guess barring a Glock, he would have gotten that kill on Starix, and that leaves you with a 3v2 retake.
Yeah, there's really not much to say. That's a big risk that a lot of AWP has taken. Vendetta, I guess you're you're like the president of pointing out exactly why people shouldn't do that. So this time you get your perfect example. That really did come back to bite them.
Yeah, and I've never seen the reward being so great of having it up in the third round, because you're most likely going up against an eco. At worst case scenario, you're going up against a force spy. So what is that op magically going to do for you that I guess a regular weapon wouldn't do? But yeah, team still opt to do it, and not surprisingly, HellRaisers decide to force up, because Markov does have some spare cash, seeing how he didn't buy up in that first Antaiko. So he's going to have an op, and Kucher's going to basically have a FAMAS, and that's about it. And they have no nades, really.
And they will be boosting Markov very quickly up onto short. He's not going to commit all the way to it. He's just hoping that someone from the Terror side is going to be pushing a little bit too aggressively, but the grenades are going to force them back, so... Yeah, bit of an attempted trick, but not really something they commit too much to at this point. And I don't know. HellRaisers lose this round. I'm not sure they can really recover from on this map here. I feel like this is kind of the round where they either stand their ground or they don't come back at all.
This is, yeah, I mean, they don't win this round. Their economy is wrecked. They're down to CZs and armor, basically. So if ever they were going to have an impact here, HellRaisers, apart from winning such a decisive pistol round as well, decisively winning that pistol round, rather, just not giving anything to Na'Vi, taking it all, and having four guys alive to just losing the anti-eco, like, they have to bounce right back here and show that they're capable of taking some control here in this map. And Na'Vi are now powering forward onto that A site. They go from Cat straight onto the site. Nobody is there to hold from HellRaisers. HellRaisers are making the right call at this point. They've lost Cat. They're trying to hold onto Long and make sure that they can give time for their teammates to rotate in.
Yeah, the bomb goes down. Look at this. The two people in B are only now just rotating. So even though HellRaisers may have known it, it's still a big risk they're taking, and I love this position from Starix. He's going to be able to tell his team that nobody's coming short, and actually, he's going to go down the middle. Angel is thinking that someone might be coming, and he's right, in fact. So Starix is going to go down, but in the meantime, it's still a 3-on-3, and that bomb is ticking away here. They got to move quick. Edward just jumps down like he was Freiburg and takes up the kill, then gets it a double, and Markolov, who's been spending the whole round down by the pit here, nothing he could do any longer. He's going to get some good kills in, but it will make no difference. They're going to lose the round, and they will only save this AWP.
And I'm actually really surprised that they opted to go for that retake. I mean, sure, I get it, they're in a tough spot and they need rounds, but they had zero nades. No nades whatsoever to actually help them with that retake. So I don't see how you're going to get up close and personal with any of the Na'Vi members and actually get closer to the bomb site without being, well, basically a practice dummy or a shooting target for the Na'Vi players.
I don't know. I mean, it feels like HellRaisers had they had something going early on, but right now they feel like they are really suffering from all the losses they've taken, and might be I don't know. They might have a hard time stabilizing the team right now. Good position from Kutri if they end up coming for Upper Dark. I don't think they're going to be checking here unless they come through T-Spawn, in which case Zeus will definitely see him. And Starix, is he going to check or not? He will check. And that's going to be the easy kill. And that actually leaves the B-bomb site completely naked. Now, I mean, I guess the goal for this round is definitely making sure Markolov can save this AWP.
Yeah, they need Markolov to live, basically. I mean, they're smoking off mid-doors as well, so this is shaping up for an A split, and this is actually worst-case scenario. I mean, Na'Vi, they're expecting somebody to rotate to B from HellRaisers. They're expecting the defense to be weakened on this A site, but HellRaisers, instead of rotating, have just gambled everything and put everybody on A, and they are going to be able to basically swat down Edward. They should be able to just stop Edward from getting in here and keep control, bring this back to a 3-on-3.
Well... The problem is that if Edward just stays here, in return, it means saving the rifles are all of a sudden going to be that much harder. Because right now, they're weirdly boxed in on Long. And Markolov is down. That leaves two pistols. Edward now creeping in. They really want to take this away from them. But should be a kill. Dosha will pick up Edward there. So that's a fine job. And they got to save these rifles. And the thing is, Na'Vi, they don't have a lot of money, but they're still actually hunting to try and take them away.
Yeah, this is going to be costly for them. But then, if they take away the rifles, HellRaisers... Well, HellRaisers are ecoing this round as well, so... It's actually... Yeah, Na'Vi should just be backing off at this point, not even taking the fight. HellRaisers are going to be able to full buy in the next round. They've held on to the AWP. They've got an AK for free now as well. So this isn't actually ideal. There is still enough money to be able to drop the AWP for Guardian, though. So at least Na'Vi have the sniper rifle for him.
Ah, was it worth it, Vendetta, to go for that, to try and pick up the rifles? I mean, in the end, they actually gave them an AK.
Actually, I have no problem with that at all, because one, they have a huge pillow that they can pull back on, so they have a few rounds that they can throw away, in a sense. And in addition to that, with the bomb plant down, everyone on their team would have been able to get at least an AK at worst.
Well, they start off this round with losing Angel, and that's not what they need. If they lose this round, apart from two of their players, nobody else can buy. And it's essentially going to be, you know, a half buy for what might be the remaining round then. They did again try and go for the boost up on short, but they don't commit to it the way that Navi did. They just have Markolov slightly pushing up. Dosha getting shot a little bit through the wall here. And Navi taking their sweet time. Oh, Guardian through the door is going to drop one and then a second one as well. The Terror from Slovakia is going to strike again, and it's now a 2-on-4. And there's still time for Na'Vi. They even have secured the B bomb site. They know that nobody's there. Guardian is down in the middle. They're very close to him. This is not a great position for an AWP, and he's not going to get the shot. But actually, in return, Markolov will, and then Starik sprays down the two remaining Hellraisers players, and we're at 15-6.
And it's not looking great for Hellraisers, to put it lightly. They will be able to get a pretty decent buy, though, for the deciding round, really. You can see Doja picking up an auto sniper here. So I think this is the desperation coming out from Hellraisers.
This is the Hail Mary?
The Hail Mary, definitely. Doja picking up the auto sniper. And Adren actually moving aggressively up in mid, but he's gonna get taken out by Guardian. And I think that's a pretty... I don't know, you have to be praying to someone if you think that's gonna work when you're playing versus Guardian.
Yeah, that kind of move is what you expect if you're playing matchmaking and you have a bot that's disconnected. Like, maybe it's gonna run through the middle, but...
Well, I feel like it's more like that kind of move is a go when you have the momentum. And yeah. You have the control of the match, say. And Na'Vi are the ones who are playing scared, right? Okay, then, maybe you go for that kind of push. But if Na'Vi have all the confidence in the world right now and they're landing all their shots and they're feeling pretty damn good... I don't know. That feels a bit too risky.
Yeah. I'd probably be more inclined to do it if you play a team that more or less don't use an op most of the time. Yeah, then I could see you doing it. I wouldn't do it if you're playing versus Kenny S or Guardian. That just seems like a death wish.
Well, Kucha's the one defending the bomb side. He's going to have to go big, but he's going to go down. Markolov looking for the cross shot. Will actually take down one. The auto sniper, I think, from Dosha helping out. But this is still a 3-on-3 retake, and... I love this position from Edward, an upper dark. That's going to leave Starix and Guardian inside. They can just focus on window and door, and Edward's going to tell them if anyone's coming upper. Angel.
And once again, Hellraisers doesn't have nades.
Yeah, and they have a SCAR 20 and an AWP for the retake. Markolov taking a headshot on Starix. He's not going to land it, though. Tries. Doja stuck at the window. Guardian will find Markolov at the doors. Doja does manage to pick off Guardian, but Starix will find the final frag. And Hellraiser's just trying to take those pick fights, Na'Vi not giving it to him. Just maintaining the man advantage and a very solid hold, kind of like this entire map has been, you know, just very thorough from Na'Vi.
Just 28 kills for Guardian in 22 rounds, that's definitely very scary. And Hellraisers, I mean, we're going to go to a second map, of course, it's a best of three. And the second map is the one that Hellraisers actually picked, which is Inferno, and they are good at playing it. But I think they're going to need to take a bit of a time out here before they get back into it, just so they get mentally prepared for winning it, because they obviously want to fight for a third map as well. And I'd love to see a third map right now. I think Hellraisers haven't shown us anywhere near what they can do. But before we do it, guys, we're going to go to a commercial break. So it's going to be about 5 minutes and we'll be back. So stay tuned. Invite your friends and let's see if Hellraisers can get back in the mix here.